So thank you very much for giving me this opportunity. So my name is Tomoko Suzuki, a postdoc at the Kapteyn Astronomical Institute. And actually I recently joined the institute like 3 months ago. And today I would like to introduce our recent study about dust, gas, and metal in star-forming galaxies at redshift 3.3 using ALMA and near-infrared spectroscopy. And here are my collaborators. So it is well known that stellar mass and the star formation rate of star-forming galaxies show a tight and positive correlation. And such a correlation is called the main sequence of star-forming galaxies. And this figure shows such a relation as the main sequence of star-forming galaxies at different epoch from redshift 0.5 to 4. And as you can see, at a given stellar mass, star formation rate monotonically increases with increasing redshift. And such a high star formation activity in high redshift galaxies considered to be supported by large gas reservoir within galaxies at the higher redshift. And when we look at star forming galaxies at a particular redshift and look into their gas properties, it is known that galaxies above the main sequence of star forming galaxies tend to be more gas rich and have higher star formation efficiency, as shown in this figure. So in the right hand panel. So this figure shows a result for local galaxies. And star formation activity in galaxies is closely related to their gas properties. And using, let's say, large number of galaxies across a wide redshift range, some studies established the scaling relation to parameterize the gas properties as a function of redshift, stellar mass, and SFL. And when we, let's say, consider the gas properties of galaxies, gas phase metallicity of galaxies is also an important quantity to be considered. And it is suggested that the gas mass and gas phase metallicity are closely related with each other. And some studies suggest that galaxies with more molecular gas mass tend to be more metal poor. And investigating these two quantities are also important in terms of the load of gas outflow and inflow processes in galaxy formation. This is because these two quantities are affected by the gas outflow and inflow processes, and the gas mass fraction and the gas phase metallicity are often used to investigate the contribution of outflows and inflow by comparing with chemical evolution models, as shown in this figure. So in this figure, Troncoso et al. 2014 compared the observational data with chemical evolution models assuming different inflow rate and outflow rate. So gas mass and gas phase metallicity are very useful to investigate to give a constraint on gas outflow and inflow processes in galaxies. So currently we have a very limited sample of galaxies with both gas mass and gas phase metallicity measurement at higher redshift, especially at redshift greater than 3. So in the first place, we need to construct such a sample of galaxies with gas mass and gas phase metallicity measurement. And with this motivation, we conducted ALMA band 6 observation of star forming galaxies at redshift 3 to 3.6 in ALMA cycle 6. And we targeted 12 star forming galaxies with metallicity measurement from the near infrared spectra taken with Keck Mosfire. And these two figures show how our ALMA target distribute on the stellar mass SFR diagram and the mass metallicity diagram. And we can see that our ALMA target tightly distribute around the star forming main sequence at redshift 3.3. So, which means that our target are, let's say, typical star forming galaxies at this redshift. And 6 out of 12 star forming galaxies are clearly detected with dust continuum in band 6. And using ALMA dust continuum flux and also multi wavelength data from optical to near infrared, we conducted SED fitting using MAGFIS to obtain the dust mass of star forming galaxies at redshift 3.3. And here I show the dust mass as a function of stellar mass for our target at redshift 3.3 together with galaxy samples at similar redshift from the literature. So we show like optical or UV selected galaxies as well as some millimeter galaxies at redshift 3 to 4. And except for submillimeter galaxies, we see a positive correlation between stellar mass and dust mass among star forming galaxies at redshift 3 to 4. And when comparing our galaxies with SMG with similar stellar mass, here we see that our galaxies have like around 1 dex lower dust mass than submillimeter galaxies at redshift 3 to 4 with similar stellar mass. So we see less dusty galaxy population at this redshift. And using this dust mass, we then convert dust mass to gas mass using the relation between gas to dust mass ratio and the gas phase metallicity from MAGDIS et al. 2012. And here I show the two gas properties, so gas mass fraction and the gas depression time scale as a function of stellar mass. And again, here I show our target at redshift 3.3 as well as galaxy samples at a similar redshift from the literature. And the solid line in each panel shows the expected value for galaxies on the main sequence at redshift 3.3 from the scaling relation of Tacconi et al. 2018. And dashed lines correspond to the cases when galaxies are 0.3 dex above and below the main sequence. So when we compare our galaxies at redshift 3.3 with scaling relation at the same redshift, we find a large scatter of gas mass fraction and the gas depression time scale at a fixed stellar mass. And given that our galaxies, as I mentioned in previous slide, our target tightly distribute along the star forming main sequence at this redshift within its typical scatter of 0.3 dex, this large scatter cannot be explained only with the deviation from the main sequence or only with the variety of star formation activity in our star forming galaxies. So these two figures suggest that the gas properties of star forming galaxies at redshift 3.3 have a large variety even when they have similar stellar mass and SFR. Okay, and then I now show how our target distribute on the gas mass fraction and gas phase metallicity diagram. And here I show our target at redshift 3.3. And in this plot, I show galaxy samples at the lower redshift from redshift 0 to redshift 2 from the literature for comparison. And when we are comparing our galaxies at redshift 3.3 with local star-forming galaxies shown in gray dots, we find that star-forming galaxies at higher redshift, our redshift 3.3, have lower gas phase metallicity than local star-forming galaxies at a fixed gas mass fraction. So star-forming galaxies at redshift 3 seems to be not chemically enriched yet as compared to local galaxies with similar gas mass fraction. And then how can we interpret this offset towards our high redshift galaxy towards lower gas phase metallicity? So for this purpose here, I introduce the gas regulator model by Penn and Maiorino 2014. And I do not explain the detail of this model, but with this model, we can track the evolution of gas mass fraction and gas phase metallicity. And these equations are established by taking into account the gas inflow to galaxies and the star formation and the chemical enrichment in galaxies and outflow driven by star formation. And here I show the model tracks assuming five different mass loading factors from 0.5 to 2.5. And when comparing the observational data point with these model tracks, we find that the offset of star forming galaxies at redshift 3.3 can be explained with the model tracks assuming higher mass loading factors. And this result suggests that the high redshift star-forming galaxies have more powerful outflow with higher mass loading factors. And our results support the, suggestion from previous studies that mass loading factors evolve with redshift. And this is summary, and I think that's it from me. And thank you very much for your attention.